Get ready to match the stars from Chips, Robert Pine, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Innocent, Susan Richardson, Richard Deacon, and Fanny Flay, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Rivers.
Okay, let's do it, shall we? Are you ready? Okay. Let's begin by greeting our two players here, Terrell Alston and Burt Waring. Champ is Terrell Alston. This lady has $7,350. Good for you.
Thank you.
And she's being challenged now by Burt Waring. We haven't met her. We'd like to find out a little bit about Burt.
Well, I'm married, and I have two children. Boy, Brett. Can I say hi to Brett?
You what?
Can I say hi to Brett?
Yeah, she's right up there. Just say hi to Brett.
Hi, Brett. How about Christy?
Christy who? Oh, that's
my
your
daughter.
Son. Yes. Oh, your daughter. Oh, I beg your pardon.
Hi, Christy.
Christy. Now, you're sure your name is B-E-R-T, not B-R-E-T?
Uh-huh.
And is it a contraction of anything?
Roberta.
Oh, okay. I'll call you Roberta if it's all right with you.
Okay. My friends call me Bert.
Oh, all right. I'd like to be your friend. I'll call you Bert.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. My husband said that to me when I first met him. I called him Dan, and he goes, my friends call me Danny. So I said, okay, Dan.
Oh, all right. We have a weirdo in our midst. Okay, we'll start the competition right after we do a little business with America. Is that all right, ladies? All right, here it is. Here we go. All right, I'll push the button here and ask Bert to make her choice of A or B.
I'll take B for Brett.
B for Brett. Larry said, my dog is really lazy. He's the only... Sorry, no half-hearted attempts, please. He's the only... Ah, shut up. My dog is really lazy. He's the only dog in the world that chases blanks. That's how lazy he is. Only dog in the world that chases blanks. Okay, Richard? You don't like that?
My dog is so lazy.
I'm thrilled.
Larry said my dog is really lazy. He's the only... Gonna get you in the parking lot. He's the only dog in the world that chases blanks.
I'm drawing a blank. Also, I can think of his fleas. His fleas.
Fleas? Yes, you did draw a blank.
Yeah.
A lazy dog. What would he chase? He would chase some immobile object, wouldn't he?
Yeah.
Something that can't move.
Yeah.
Such as?
Trees.
Trees can't move.
Well, what about something that moves?
Feel free. I don't get it often, so.
Right.
You don't?
Yeah, what?
What about something that moves slowly?
Yeah.
Well, that'd be all right.
Okay. Turtles.
Turtle would be good. Something slower.
I said turtle.
Okay. Something slow or immobile is the response we seek here. What do you say,
I said
Susan?
Snails.
Snails is good. Another slow thing?
I said tails. Maybe I should have said tail.
No.
Single
no.
tail. No.
Uh-uh.
Shouldn't have said anything.
No, shouldn't have said anything. All right, Fanny.
I said turtles.
Turtles, yes. Well, you know what? No one said parked cars, did they?
No, I didn't do it.
Dogs are notorious for chasing cars, aren't they?
Yes.
And a lazy dog would chase a parked car.
Yes.
Very good.
Okay, get
somebody
the other bunch of celebrities
it.
In here. We'll whip these right out. We've got a little bench in here. All right, Carol, we've got a question for you, which reads as follows. The producer said, mm-hmm. Last week, we had the biggest flop in the history of Hollywood. It happened when blank tripped. Are you thinking about this, Carol?
You put down my name, I'm going to kill you.
The producer said, last week, we had the biggest flop in the history of Hollywood. It happened when blank tripped.
I'm going blank, too. I'm going to say Raquel Welch.
Raquel Welch? What's wrong with that? That's a perfect answer because, you know, she would have a tendency to lean forward and sometimes fall down.
You wish.
What'd you say?
I had a bigger flop in mind. I had
King Kong is another good answer. Finally, those are the two possibilities, King Kong or Raquel or any of those people.
Well, she's not an obesity case. She's just got...
Well, that's it.
From here to Encino, I understand.
Top heavy in front there.
Yes, I said Jackie Gleason.
That would be a big flop?
You'd make a lot. Thank you.
He weighs a lot,
yes. Two ladies in the front, I'd like the picture, please.
King Kong.
King Kong. All right. Carol said Raquel Welch. What do you say, Susan?
I had the same idea, but it would be a bigger flop. Dolly Parton?
Dolly Parton. They got the idea. I guess they're sharper than I thought they were.
Oh, they would have said, if she'd said Twiggy, they would have gone, hooray!
Now, wait a minute. Say Twiggy.
Twiggy.
Hi, hi.
All right. Okay, Deke.
Question of either writing down my own name or Dumbo.
Dumbo came out on top, and that would hurt. Okay, Fanny.
Kate Smith.
Kate Smith.
I love it.
Why is okay, Kate so Smith there we are at the end of round one. What do we got? Nothing. Ladies, shape up.
Now we have this message for you, America. Pay attention.
Here we go. Round two. This is the final round. Bert, again, you have a choice of A or B.
I'll take B. It was so good to me last time.
All right, Bert. Dumb Dora is so dumb. Not bad. Once she went up to a doorman and said, if you're a doorman, where's your blank? Bert Waring, Dumb Dora, so dumb, once she went up to a doorman and said, if you're a doorman, where's your blank?
Knob.
Oh! Would you tell him he had a dumb answer again? He's going to come up with knob again?
You know what?
What?
She's right.
Well, this time she's really right.
Yeah, she's really right. This is Dumb Robert. I said a door.
Where's your door? Well, it's either door or knob, I guess. What do you say?
I just tried to comfort him because he's cute and he was already in the slot and all. I thought, well, you know, what the heck. I said knob.
Okay, one for her. What do you say, Charles?
Knob!
Two for her.
Four.
Four.
Right.
Manny, show us your knob. Okay. What do you got there? Four. Four knobs for her. Carol, you got to be four to tie, five to win. Billy Jim said, my girlfriend is a real Georgia peach. She has fuzz on her blank.
She has fuzz on her what?
She has fuzz on her blank. My girlfriend's a real Georgia peach. She has fuzz on her blank. Okay. Carol? Billy Jim said, my girlfriend's a real Georgia peach. She has fuzz on her blank.
Fuzz on her face.
Fuzz on her face. Fuzz on her face. You in my mind. Hello.
Hi, Gene. I was thinking of peaches and...
spherical objects?
Yes. Pits.
Oh, pits. Yeah. It scared
not
me
bad.
There.
Now, come on.
Now, you... fright me there for a minute.
Yeah.
There.
Okay. Me too.
Yeah.
Fuzz on her pits. Or fuzz on her face. Shaved
fuzz
every
on her
day.
Face. All right. There's one.
He wouldn't say face. He wouldn't talk like that. He would say she has fuzz on her puss.
On her face. Okay. All right. Score is now 4-2. Susan? My girlfriend's a real Georgia peach. She has fuzz on her
face.
4-3 to score. Okay, Deke.
Here's for the ugliest picture of the week. Boobs.
Oh. Well, really, now you must match Fanny to stay in the game and achieve a tie. What have we got there, Fanny?
I said she had fuzz on her teeth.
On her teeth? That means Bert Waring wins the game. Okay, a little blue dot if you would, please. Well, Carol Alston is leaving here with a pretty good bundle of cash. Well, not in her pocket, but it'll come your way very soon, Carol. $7,350.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you very much.
Now, we're going to spin her off. And here's the big board for you. There's the star wheel for you. It's all for your benefit, my dear. Take advantage of it while you may. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. The world blank. $500 for matching the most popular answer. And then if you match the answer they wrote down second most often, you get $250. And then for the third, you get $100. Three of the six loonies will help you.
Susan, the world goes round, turns?
The world turns.
The world turns.
Is that what you want to say?
The world goes round.
Fanny, have you got one?
The World Almanac.
The World Almanac.
Brett, what is that place out there where you have to get in your car and drive for hours and it has funny seals and all and animal and sea folk and everything?
No.
So
no.
What is it, dear?
World
According to God. SeaWorld. Oh, a wonderful book. The most wonderful book in the world that the whole world should read.
Is
written
it
by John Irving, called The World According to Garp.
The World According to Garp. Okay. The World According to
Garp. Number three, you can't worry about it.
And The World Turns and The World Almanac are the three they've given you. Now you think about it and give us one of your own or choose one of those. What is your pleasure?
I like your answers, but I'm going to choose my own, the World Series.
Okay. Let's find out if we got it there. She's on her own with the World Series. May we see the $100 number? The world is round. Of course, any fool knows that. I don't know why they even bothered to say it there. Except that technically it's not. It's an oblate spheroid, which means a little flat on the top, a little flat on the bottom. But aren't we all? Anyway, here we go with a $250 response. The world turns. That was
here
Susan's
is
answer.
The World Series, Bert. I know
you
it's
think it's
going to
be the World Series? Do you think? Well, you talked her into it. And if you're wrong, you got to give her the money. May we see the big one, please? Yes, you're right. Very good judgment on your part, Bert Waring. Now you've won the $500 there. Means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount or $5,000. However, if you're a good wheel spinner here now, you can double your money and play for $10,000. You want me to hold that for you? Yeah, okay. What is that? Oh.
Baby,
good
double.
Luck to you. That's all for a double. Bert Waring. Come on. Good for you, Bert Waring. You are playing for $10,000 with Fanny Flagg. And here we go. Ready? This is it. Blank, Harry, H-A-R-R-Y, blank, Harry, H-A-R-R-Y. Fanny's finished. Now give us the answer that she's written on the card. If you do that, you get $10,000. What do you say to that?
Dirty Harry.
What's the matter, Fanny? Oh.
I was a big fan of Harry Truman's.
Really?
So, oh, dirty!
$600. Congratulations to Bert Waring. And now we'll do a little message for America. Hey, pal. All right. Bert was just saying Dirty Harry's her favorite movie.
Oh, and, that's great.
It
wonderful.
Worked out very well for her. She's got a lot of money, over $10,000. In
Las Vegas. She,
really? You're going to blow it all now, huh?
Not all of it.
All right. I'll allow you 10%, but no more. Okay?
That sounds like enough. I'll have a good time.
Now let's all say hello and welcome Kathy Kelleher. Hello, Kathy.
Welcome.
Thank you.
We want to get acquainted with you before we start. We find out where you're from and what you do with your life and what your dreams and hopes and aspirations and ambitions are. How many novels you've written in the past 3 years. Anything you want to say, Kathy?
Well, I was born in Cut Bank, Montana. And right now I'm a teacher's aide in special education at Rigetti High School in Santa Maria. And I have a 9-year-old daughter named Amy.
Okay. Well, we welcome you and wish you the best of luck. And we'll begin by asking you to choose A or B here.
B, please.
B it is for Kathy Kelleher. And B says this. You're all familiar with the fact that the human body is 78% water.
Thank God.
Yes. Well.
I thought it was pounds I wanted to get rid of, and it's just water.
Go, Gene, go.
To continue.
Yes.
This is not so.
Is it really just water?
78% water. We're all comprised of 78% water. But not so with Howard Cosell. 78% of his body is blank. Kathy, are you, being a school teacher, you must know that we are comprised of 78% fluids, right?
Yes, that's right.
And Howard Cosell is the exception. 78% of his body is...
Mouth.
Mouth!
All right, you got it.
She's right.
She came up with the definitive answer.
She's right, I'm wrong. Baloney.
That's kind of I think it's a wonderful answer. Even though it doesn't match, it's a nifty answer. 78% of Howard Cosell is comprised of baloney. What do you say?
I said 78% is mouth.
Really? Oh, really?
Well, you don't gas, you know, you explode.
Yes, I know. We understand.
Explain it.
Shut up or you'll mouth. Okay.
I think he's a very good sportscaster. I really
well,
do.
I know. You think he's a very good sportscaster?
I did until I came here. And now you people all made me feel like hot air.
Hot air. Okay. Well, Kathy, so far, no match. Let's see what we have from Susan here. Mind the mouth.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. You got one, Mighty Mouth, for sweet Kathy Kelleher?
I don't got this for nothing.
Mouth it is. Yes?
78% of his body was, I thought, spoiled.
Spoiled. Rotten to the core. That's Cosell. Okay, so that's two for her. You stand by for yours. Right now we have a message for you. Well, we don't have time for another question, ladies, but we'll look forward to seeing both Bert Waring and Kathy Kelleher next time. And we'll look forward to seeing some of you next time. You go to the Laughing Academy and report to Dr. Watkins. He has some wet sheets he's going to wrap you in for the night and keep you there. Well, you can come back.
Okay, may I?
Yes.
Thank you.
You come back. Well, I don't know. How about a month and a half, whenever you're
after
ready.
After I get rid of 75% water, huh?
That's right. Get rid of the water because we got enough troubles around here. Don't forget to watch Robert Pine on Chips.
Yes. And don't forget Fanny on Candid Camera.
Oh, Fanny on Candid Camera,
yes,
right?
Yes, and I have the lead in Death Valley Days coming up.
Death Valley Days. With the old ranger, I remember well. Susan Richardson on Eight is Enough. Say hello to my old friend Dickie Van Patten, will you? Okay, my dear. Next time we get together, these are the bodies you'll see.
Bowser, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Breanne Leary, Bob Barker, and George Dillowan.
Team Reverend here, join us next time for Match Game 79. Goodbye.